So guys, I will tell you this. Handling a situation can be very stressful. But when it comes to some people, handling a situation can be very hysterical. Well, let me tell you the story. I remember a time where I was in the sixth grade, and I got my ass kicked. And I had to face the biggest bully, and that person took my lunch money every single day. But I had to get it back, though. So, it comes down to assembly, and I started approaching the person, and I said, "Yo, Nicole! Give me my money, man!" And I was like, "Give me my money, or else you're gonna face the fist of fury." Laugh now, cry later. And then my mom told me about fighting a girl, and she was like, "TJ, don't you hit that girl." Well, let's just say I was blinded by her own rage of the bully. And then 2 hours later, I woke up in the nurse's office with a slice of pickle on my eyes. And let's just say this, I was hurt, bamboozled, and I took two hits right there, and then another one right there. Man, but it was crazy. So Nicole, if you are watching this, even though your name is Nick and Cole, I want my rematch.
She even called me that word. You know what that word is? Come on, man. I need to go call her right now, man.
No. I don't consent. It's my phone.
You're right. I should have called her. You know, matter of fact, maybe I should call her, you know, maybe out tonight. Like, maybe tomorrow.
You ever feel like the children just don't respect? And do you feel like that God has punished you with their serious offspring that you can't discipline them properly? I have a solution for you. Introducing the belt. So the belt is an effective way that the children are not lacking common sense. I know you're at home asking yourself, Mr. Ojide, when is the right time to use the belt? I will tell you. Number one, when they don't respect. Number two, when they don't listen. Number three, well, they can see their way to not getting a beating. Number four, when they are becoming and unbecoming. And number five, when their friends have A's and while you guys have B and C minus. Now time to check up on our favorite boy, Enoch.
Yo, what's going on, TJ?
How you doing, bro? How you doing, bro?
That's what's up.
Yeah, so how the class is going?
You know, a couple of A's here and there, maybe a B or two.
Oh, you said a B?
Yeah, might even a C in there, too.
Oh, no.
And that is how we use the belts.
Yo, what's your name?
Me?
Yes, you, Mr. Black Man. Oh, Mick. Mick, get your ass up.
You know what?
Yeah, I'm Michael Jordan.
Huh? And I'm Michael Jackson. Who are you?
I'm your new coach, Coach TJ.
I ain't heard about that.
You find this amusing?
Well, you're not my coach, bro.
Do you take me for a joke?
I mean, you got me laughing.
I know what you're thinking. Coach TJ is just a freshman. We don't need to listen to him. We can do all the nonsense we want. Well, that's where you're wrong. Nonsense, won't you? It's all right.
What was that?
Show me how you dribble.
You know me, I'm starting poker. I'm starting like,
show the males you are.
No! That's not how you do it, man. This is how we do it. Right here we go. And then, bam! That's how you dribble the ball.
Well, that's whack.
You think I'm whack because this is my first day. I'm going to teach you all the steps. So are you ready?
No.
Well, I know the steps are ready. I think you are ready, okay? You have something to do?
No.
Perfect. Come on, man. Let's go.
Where are we going?
Oh, we just going to take a little walk, Mr. Mick.
Yeah, Mickey Mouse. I don't even get it, okay? And I know you must be failing English because that's the only language you speak. Let's go.
So, show me how you dribble. No! That is not how you dribble the ball. This is how you do it right over here, the old school way. And bam! That's how you dribble the ball.
That's whack and old.
You find this amusing?
You got me laughing.
You think I'm a joke?
I ain't necessarily say that.
Come on, you gon' practice.
Practice what? My skills is tight.
Not the way from I'm seeing with all them legs. Okay, so come on, let's go, man. We got a lot of work to do.
You again.
What? What happened?
What you want from me, man?
Nothing. I'm just checking up on my favorite players, son.
Dude, they're not my coach.
So, what's going on? What you up to?
You know, it was Valentine's Day yesterday. You know, I gotta check on my girl, man.
Oh, that's so sweet. That is so touching.
Give me the damn phone! This is business! We got a lot of work to do, man.
What's up, young blood? Where my money?
Oh, hell no! You see what you did?
Yo!
What?
I know you just had a little my damn face.
No. Never at all, man.
Scratch that. Who's the coach?
I'm the coach. You ain't no coach! Yes, I am! No, you're not!
Alright, so who's the freshman?
That's it.
Damn it,
man!
How's he doing?
boy plays worse than 50 Cent, bro.
Really?
Yeah.
Let me see.
Okay, cool. So you want to see how I can coach him?
Yeah, I want to see it right now.
All
right,
cool. So, Nick, you going to work. You going to sweat. And you going to learn.
Wait, where are you going?
I gotta go to the hospital.
Oh, no. You don't need to go to the hospital. Prince is your doctor now.
That's right.
So, Dr. Prince, how is he doing?
Wacky. He can do a little better.
Yeah, I hear that.
He ain't no doctor.
Are you eyeballing him, boy?
Oh, I got this.
Are you eyeballing me, boy? All right, cool. Okay, it's okay. Matter of fact, I'm gonna need you to start running right now. Let's go.
Move it.
Boy, this ain't no picnic. Pick a basketball. Go, go, go. You almost killed Scooter Jr. It's okay. Daddy's here.
My whole life has changed since you came in. I'm not better.
What's up, TJ? Nothing much, man. Just chilling. What you listening to?
I was listening to some NBA Youngboy.
Ah.
Yes, I remember those classes.
Oh, no, so you're gonna want this.
What? I got a new recruit.
You got a new recruit?
I got a new recruit.
I'll talk to you later, TJ.
Okay, no problem. Mm-hmm. Come on in, bro!
Yes, sir. Malcolm?
Yo!
What's good, bro?
Oh my god, how you doing?
How you know Malcolm?
I mean, I just found him in the lounge. We started having a conversation, so I figured you might know him.
Do you know who he is?
Tell me.
Bro, you scored 44 points on a top 25 team last year, bro.
Say it ain't so.
I did.
Nice.
So, yeah. Wait. How'd you come in contact with him?
To be honest with you, I had no school to go to. And he just saw me with this basketball. He's like, hey, you play basketball? I was like, yeah, man. And then conversation went from there, and now I'm here.
And what did you say to him for him to listen to you?
I just told him I was the head coach.
He does good, right?
I am the head coach. I don't know what he's talking about. He ain't doing good in his classes. How do you feel English when that's the only language you speak, bro?
Hold on. I don't even take English. Second off, he's not a coach. Bro, forget him.
No. 3 hours later.
Can you move it along? I'm all out of time cards.
Yo.
Yo! Where the hell y'all been?
Hold on. Why are you yelling, bro?
What are you talking about?
We had practice.
I'm not going to no practice, bro.
I'm chilling either way, though. I don't go to practice, bro.
I'm not practice, bro.
I know you're new here, but don't get too comfortable now. I expected this more from you. I blame you for not showing up on time.
Okay. What's your point?
Give me 30 laps around this room.
No.
If you don't do it, I'm gonna call the hood coach right now.
Yep, that's what you gotta do. Start them laps.
What you talking about? They let me in for free.
That doesn't tell me what you're doing here.
Oh, nothing, Don. I check up on my favorite player, my son.
One, not my coach. Two, I quit the team. Good night.
You quit the team? How?
Oh, I quit the team, bro.
No. That doesn't sound right. How did you quit the team less than one day?
Bro, basketball just isn't for me anymore, bro.
You saying back? You say? Oh hell no! How did you quit less than one day?
You know, basketball just don't love me, man.
You said basketball don't love you.
Is she not the girl of your dreams? The basketball?
Sometimes, you know, the girl of the dreams isn't always right for you.
Get your ass up, boy! You need to get out there and play the game, man. Listen, you got the whole team out there waiting for you, and I got the girl out there. It's a hot girl waiting for me, so do not mess this up for me, man.
What's a hot girl got to do with me?
Nothing, but this is my night, all right? And maybe your night, but most importantly, it's my night. So grab your bag and get out there.
All right, man. I'm gonna hate to have to tell you that I told you so.
All right, now you gotta go.
It's cold, bro.
There's a thing out there, bro.
Bro, that was because of you, bro.
Yeah, I was happy to help you.
I don't really think I was going to go to that game today, man.
Well, I just wanted you to get out of bed, so you had to do what you had to do.
Now, that's great, bro.
Yep. So now, since I helped you, now you got to help me.
Oh, you still got the hot date, right?
Yeah.
Oh, so you want to know about the golden ticket?
Yes, I do.
Let's take a look, man.
Okay, cool.
Let's take a look. Yeah. All right, so basically, the golden ticket is when you get a girl to come to your room. You know, uh-huh. Throw the sock in the door.
Oh, hey! I didn't see y'all there. So I want to talk to y'all about this party that's happening tonight. And the event is called Freak and Fest. Freak Fest. Now, I want to tell you it's going to be great, and I expect y'all to go. And come with me. We got a lot of business to talk about.
Yeah, my boy.
Bro, what
do
you want from me now, bro?
Nothing. I just want to talk to you about this party that's coming up tonight. Party? You know, Flaco and Princess party that's happening tonight. And I'm hosting.
Yo, Prince, you having a party? Yeah.
What? So good spice.
What's up?
10 and 3.
See? You gotta come, man.
Yeah, how much is it, though?
$10.
It's $10? All night?
Yeah. It's $12.30.
Yeah. So we gotta beat her before 11:30.
Yeah, we gotta beat her at 11:30, for example. And I got a girl right over here, right? So you coming to my party tonight?
Guy like you, I know you got that.
I'm trying to make everybody happy, especially the radio hosts and stuff, bro.
You know what you gotta do tonight, man? Gotta get them dances.
Yeah, and there you have it. And also, there's going to be some whipped cream in the lake. Y'all should really go. Y'all should go. Y'all need to come, all right? Y'all should go.